Hey everybody, it's episode 7 of season 1 of Charmed. Last time we had a fun wedding episode. Oh, it was fun. You know, there were no weird ancient oaths and deals and contracts. None of that stuff. It was just a normal wedding, you know? Gotta pick the cake and you gotta pick what the bridesmaids are gonna be wearing. And, you know, Phoebe and Piper were invited. And, yeah, that was fun. This time is going to be no weddings. We're just going to have a quiet episode about flowers. It's going to be a flower episode. So keep your eye open for flowers and all sorts of, you know, horticultural and botanical things. Oh, and Prue's, yeah, this is something I meant to mention in the end of the last episode. The person Prue is working for, and also his assist, whoever she is, you know, the one who was there at Prue's interview, they're deeply embedded in the underworld, you know? They know about weird stuff, and, yeah. So they know, they don't know about Prue, but they know that all that, well, maybe they do know about Prue, but they, you know, they may or may not be evil, or maybe they're just capitalists, you know? So we'll find out about them. Ooh. What are we doing? This is like the start of episode 1. Gotta have the candles.
Come to me, Callie.
Ooh, Callie.
I conjure thee, Callie.
Hey, Callie.
I'm here, Aviva.
She in the mirror?
Be patient, Aviva. But I've done everything that you've asked. I've followed the Hallowell sisters. I know their every move. You must make them want you as badly as you want them. Are you ready to receive your power?
Sure.
What's going on? You know I am. If I give it to you, you must use it only as I say. I promise.
Anything you say.
Reach for the mirror. Put out your hands.
What's the power? What can she do?
You know what to do.
Oh, jeez. Give her 2 seconds till she's out of the room. So she doesn't see that part. As if we didn't know she was evil. Oh! Leo! Oh, jeez.
I think I see.
Piper. Piper. Yeah, jeez,
there's
Piper.
There's definitely something here.
Definitely.
Piper.
My Santa, you've changed.
Phoebe.
Thanks for looking. I'm sure you must be hungry after all that work.
Yeah, stay. Work.
Oh, that's just Piper. She's got to be everyone's mom. Think of her as your mom. I know I do.
Let me go put these flyers up first, and I'll be right back, okay?
We're missing the cat. Where'd the cat go?
Oof, quite possibly the finest glutes in the city.
Oh dear. I'm glad he came back. Oh, jeez, we're following him. Where did that cat go? Oh, this is the girl. We don't want them to find the cat. Is the cat getting in the way of the mirror goddess's plans? I found the cat. It's in the star credit sequence. I love this guy. Pulling the drum.
Here you go, Leo. Non-fat milk, right? Just don't call me Mom.
Yeah, yeah. Don't listen to Phoebe.
I hope you're right.
Andy's a cop, you're a witch.
Hey Prue, do you notice the new guy?
Hey, Leo, how's it going?
Good.
Nice outfit. For 9 o'clock in the morning with no place to go.
I'm glad you like it. Leo, come here.
Oh, jeez, that's very forward.
Phoebe! I think that Piper likes Leo.
Yeah.
Your point being...
Come on, Phoebe.
Never mind, classic Phoebe. Okay, look, Prue, I think we need to put some major closure on this.
I wasn't with Roger.
I'm still gonna hear about Roger. Piper, am I a boyfriend thief?
Yes. No, I mean...
Totally.
Yeah.
Billy Wilson.
Will eighth grade Billy Wilson? You were all over him, with your breasts all... Whatever. I didn't even have breasts back then. You've always had breasts.
It's just gentle competition, you know?
So we can just consider this a friendly competition.
That's what I was saying.
Sibling rivalry.
It's gonna get messy. Wasn't she supposed to find his sisters?
Aviva, open the door.
Hey, Mom, jeez.
It's my apartment, Aviva.
So you keep reminding me, Aunt Jackie.
Oh, it's Aunt, not her mom.
How come you haven't called my mom yet? To see how she's doing?
She has to take responsibility for her own actions.
She's not in jail, she's in rehab.
I thought she was dead.
Whatever.
Now I know why she turns to the mirror goddess. Her aunt doesn't understand her. Her mom's in rehab.
Ever seen Lethal Weapon 3?
Not very romantic.
Remember video stores?
Doesn't really matter what we pick anyway. Probably never get around to watching it.
What?
Oh yeah?
What does that mean?
Pretty cocky.
Actually, what I meant was something always seems to come up.
Yeah, your sisters.
Get in our way.
That's not true.
It's always something. It's
sometimes true, but there's always a perfectly good reason.
Do you know where our cat is?
You, me, tonight. Nothing, and I mean nothing, will get in our way, guaranteed.
Oh. I'll hold you to that.
I conjure thee, Callie. I'm going crazy here, Callie. I can't wait any longer.
You must gain their trust first.
How do
you
I
must let them welcome this? You into their coven.
Oh, she stole the cat. This makes a lot of sense.
About done for the day?
Oh, he's been there like all day. Jeez.
Well, Prue has a date tonight, so we kind of got to clear out. I was thinking about catching a movie. Want to go?
Hey, I had to pause it because of noise, but gives us a chance to talk about the episode without missing stuff. Phoebe and Piper vying for Leo's attention. What's going to happen here with Piper inviting him for a movie? Is he going to say, Phoebe already asked me to dinner. Sorry. We've already established that Phoebe's like a boyfriend stealer, but this doesn't count, you know? Although Piper is clearly interested, you know, it's not like she's dating him. But, so I was going to say, initially my thought was, poor Piper. But I think that's being unfair to Phoebe. You know, she's allowed to be happy too, you know? Just because she's maybe gets more... She's more confident she gets out there more. You know? But instinctively, I'm on Piper's side. But I think I'm just going to let it play out and see what happens. I don't know if either of them are going... Maybe he's in a relationship already. You know? Maybe he's a cat. You don't know. You don't know what the deal is with him. You know? So... the other story with Aviva, she's just angry, you know. Her life is difficult. She's living with, you saw who she was living with, Miss. I'm going to come into your room and then start opening windows and just leave me alone, you know. Can't you see I'm writing in my diary? Can't you see I'm pissed off at the world? Don't even think of looking in my mirror. The mirror demon is, keep calling her a mirror goddess. The mirror demon is, no, ulterior motives. What's going to happen? What's she supposed to do with her powers when she gets into the Hollywood's domain? Here's her cat. Shh. I'm here to teach you about fire. No, I'm burning. You know, burnt the witches. Oh shit, Salem. Salem all over again. Anyway, let's get back into it. See what Leo has to say about the situation. About the dating situation. It's good that he came back. And I was waiting for him. Glad we didn't have to wait too long.
So what time's the movie?
I got it.
Cool.
Kit, oh my god, we were worried sick.
I was just walking by and I saw one of your flyers and poof, there she was.
Here she is. She's in.
Wow.
What's she looking for?
You must be starving.
I fed her.
And she didn't try to scratch you?
Let me clean up before the movie.
Okay. Movie?
A war movie.
I love war movies. Mind if I tag along?
Sure. Why not?
Aviva can come too.
What's your name? Oh, no, I don't want your money.
Oh, everybody's here.
Hey, I thought we all had plans tonight. But we need to talk.
About
what?
Shh.
About Wicca. Andy Trudeau, this is Leo Wyatt. You guys...
You talk to Leo?
Don't you understand? I'm one of you. No!
Oh, she stopped us. Good.
Very cool.
What are we gonna do?
You didn't freeze. It's because I'm a witch, too.
She's a witch.
A what?
True.
Okay, you need to get out of here now. What? Why? Because we don't know who the hell you really are. Not leaving. Leave now or else. Or else what?
Prue will kick your ass, little lady. Oh, she left.
Yeah, yeah.
Ooh, popcorn.
Hey, where did that girl go?
What girl?
She just... left.
Yeah, that was smooth. Yeah, no suspicions there.
Was it the oldest? Was it Prue who sent you away? You must separate them. Together they're charmed, impenetrable.
But what if they don't want me?
Phoebe will. In her own way, she's searching for someone to relate to.
Does she know all this? What's her angle?
You're the one who came to me, remember?
I know. I want a family. I don't have anybody. What do you get out of it?
Good question.
Well, magic is old and powerful, and I want it.
Oh, okay. She's very open about it.
Make Phoebe covet your power.
I wanted you to stay. You have to believe me.
Then what happened? Why'd you want me to leave all of a sudden?
Sister stuff, I can't really go into detail without
betraying someone's secret. Look,
Andy, good. I'm unpredictable, okay?
I just want to have a normal date, that's all. Is that too much to ask for?
All right, let's just try again.
Maybe do it outside of the house.
Tonight, 8 o'clock.
I'll be there.
Just got done dodging Leo's questions about her. That was close. The question is, who is she? And what does she want?
Yeah, a bad witch with a really cool power. Better than mine, that's for sure.
Ooh, Phoebe's thinking about better powers.
Besides, if she's a witch, she probably feels just as alone as we do. Maybe she just needs some friends.
Or maybe she's out to destroy us. It wouldn't be the first time. Until we know who she really is, let's just steer clear, okay?
Okay. Phoebe's not going to steer clear. I love the way none of them come back to see who the phone's
Hello.
For.
Aviva?
Oh. That's why they didn't come back.
I'm so glad that you came. You didn't tell your bitch sister about this, did you?
Jeez.
Hey, watch your mouth. Prue had every right to be upset with what you did. It's funny how you knew that I was talking about Prue and not... Let's go for a ride.
Ooh, a nice car. Hey, Leo.
Table for one, sir?
I'm impressed.
Good. I mean, good that you came here, as opposed to the house and Phoebe.
What? That's a strange thing to say.
Hungry?
You're big on food, aren't you?
You
know, and that's good. You know, actually, in the Mayan culture, the cook was second in the hierarchy of the medicine man.
The Mayan culture?
Does Phoebe work here, too?
Phoebe. She's probably at her gay and lesbian group right about now.
Friendly sibling rivalry. You know, you gotta undercut them somehow.
The parlor, that's the conservatory. Oh, I love it here. You are liking this, Leo?
Maybe.
Oh, she's connecting with her.
I mean, how could he not? You were so gorgeous.
Flattery.
Cast a spell on him or something.
They tried that before, sort of.
I have this teacher. Who is she? Another witch, like a high priestess or something. She said you were the coolest, that I would like you the best. Is your room up there?
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
Oh, maybe she is at the lesbian meeting that Piper was talking about.
You're gonna love it. I promise.
Kat, do you want to save me from this? No? Maybe it's just a cat.
I like mirrors. They never lie to you.
Not true.
Do you want to see something incredible? I'll show you my power if you show me yours.
Oh, jeez.
Anybody home?
It is a date.
Better not be. Don't be afraid. Watch. She's giving it to you too. The power. Here.
What can she do?
It's the power of heat.
Oh, flowers. Remember I said it was a flower episode?
Whoa. Phoebe, are you... Prue, what are you doing? Aviva?
No, she treats you worse than my aunt treats me. It's not right. It's
okay. Yeah, you're just like an aunt. Coming into my room, trying to open all my windows. Stop me having fun with my friends.
Chianti, body heat, what do you think?
I can explain. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
It's getting ridiculous.
I know. Believe me, you have every right to be upset. Tomorrow, Quake, 1 o'clock, please.
How about we go out of town for our date? Can't get interrupted if we're not in the plot.
What the hell is she doing here? What's the matter with you?
This is her house too, okay? She can do whatever she wants.
Yeah.
She's not what you think she is.
She doesn't understand, Phoebe.
She's just a brat, Prue. Phoebe's working her, you know?
I hate her, and I wish that she were dead.
Aviva, what's going on? Who's in there with you?
I wish my aunt was dead.
Get out of my room!
How dare you speak to me in that tone?
Oh, she's going down. Oh, shit. Get out of there! Get out of there! Roll! Oh, I think she might be dead. She's just taking a nap. See? No body bag.
You must go back to the Halliwells. Piper won't stop you. Only Prue stands in our way.
Yeah, frickin' Prue.
You must take Prue's place in the power of three.
Yeah, you could be the new Prue. Younger, brattier. If Evie will come around, she's not a bad kid.
You poor thing, you're shivering. I'm okay. Her aunt was admitted to the hospital. How did she fall again? I don't know.
She just tripped.
I promise, if you just let me spend the night, I'll tell you everything you want to know about me tomorrow. She can sleep in my room. No magic. I swear.
Okay.
Now.
Oh, what are we doing? Are we gonna kill Prue in her sleep?
What are you doing?
Oh, just checking on your sister.
I was just looking for the bathroom. Oh, it's down the hall to the right.
Oh, Piper's onto her. Can we cast a protection spell? Or something? Just stand there all night?
We lost our cat and she found it for us.
Oh, that's what she was hiding.
In the closet.
She wouldn't let me go anywhere near it. She's a strange kid. And all sorts of weird stuff. Black magic, voodoo, God knows what else.
The cure.
Sometimes I swear, I even hear other voices.
Do you mind if I stop by your place and pick up some things for Aviva?
Do you mind if I snoop around?
Prue, I know she was going to the hospital.
That's all right, Piper. Thanks for trying.
Andy. How about they stop making plans and just go for a date all the time until it happens? Oh, a diary. Where all the secrets are. It's bad form. You shouldn't be reading this, you know? I know she's dark and troubled.
Kelly says we're close to taking over the Hallowell Coven. I hate lying to them.
Hello.
Phoebe, whatever you do, don't let Aviva out of your sight, okay?
Explain it to her.
Yeah, sure. Do you mind if I go upstairs and lie down?
Sure, go ahead.
How's she taking off? What's she doing in that room? Setting a trap?
Wait, you're finished already?
Well, yeah, I'll be back tomorrow to make sure everybody's happy with my work. Just out of curiosity. Are you an Aviva?
Piper said what?
Nothing. I think I need some water.
Well, whatever she said, you should probably take it with a grain of salt. Sometimes her medication makes her say the strangest
medication.
Things.
They're doing each other no favors. Oh, visions. Forgot she had vision.
Oh my god, Aviva.
Prue's home.
Oh no.
It's okay, just stop her going into her room.
Aviva? Aviva! What the hell are you doing?
Phoebe, I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's only a fireball. What's the worst that could have happened? Horribly burning scars?
Aviva had some candles lit, and I guess the sweater got too close.
Yeah.
Sure caught fire fast.
Leo, we got this. We won't want you to be late for that.
Yeah, get out of here, Leo.
Well, I'll stop by later, see how you're doing.
Great.
You were right about Aviva. She's evil.
Maybe she's not, but she is being used by an evil spirit, and I think I know which one, so...
Oh.
Come on.
Is she in the book? Kali?
I don't want to be a witch anymore.
But you haven't finished what we started.
I have to leave.
Aren't you going to say goodbye first?
Mm-hmm.
Touch the mirror, Aviva.
Jump out the window.
Touch the mirror, and I'll go away too.
She's gonna go inside you. Somehow, you're gonna swap places, I don't know. Don't touch the mirror. Oh, she's inside her.
An evil sorceress cursed into her own dimension. She appears in reflections.
Does it say anything about how to get rid of her?
Yeah, to get rid of her, shatter her reflection.
Get a mirror.
You're not Aviva.
You're not kidding.
Phoebe, help me!
Never mind.
That's it, freeze her! Aviva doesn't freeze.
Yeah, but Kali will.
Oh, good thinking.
No!
Oh, that's so cool. That's really cool. Now we get a mirror and shatter the reflection? I don't know. Yeah.
Throw the mirror!
Smash her again!
Thanks for the dress. No problem, it's Prue's.
I love the little tiny comments.
The one thing I learned...
Mirror.
You just gotta be yourself.
What if yourself sucks?
Well, you don't have to worry about that. Okay, now remember.
Don't tell anyone.
Not tell
anybody
anyone
about,
us Halliwell sisters. I promise. Okay.
Oh, we're gonna have a date. Picnic in the park.
Can we talk?
Just here.
Is there really anything to talk about?
Andy.
Sidewalk party.
I mean, let's face it, one of us is obviously more interested in this relationship than the other.
I can explain.
No, you can't. Or you won't.
She'll have to tell him the truth eventually.
Damn it, Prue. I still love you. I'm not saying you have to explain it all to me, Prue. That's your prerogative. All I'm saying is it hurts that you don't trust me enough.
It's just something that I don't know if I can ever share with anybody.
All I know is there's nothing more I can say or do to reassure you that I'm there for you.
Are you saying that you don't want to see me anymore?
I don't know what I want anymore.
They're not breaking up. They can't break up. It was a goofy episode. Can't break up in a goofy episode. Oh, it's over. Eventually, Prue's gonna have to... Either Andy will become evil and start trying to kill them, or he'll vanish from the show, mysteriously, or she'll tell him. Because he's into... He knows all this stuff, you know? He's very well-versed in all that stuff. You know what I'm talking about? So he would be fine with it, but she doesn't know that. And his partner knows that he's into all that stuff. Oh, we haven't seen him in a while. Morris. I alternate between calling him Morris and Norris. I should just call him Darryl. No confusion then. So, this is an episode in three parts. The main storyline is with Aviva going through a phase in her life where things are just happening to her. She doesn't have much control over it. I don't know where her father is, but her mother is deeply troubled and she's living with her aunt. Who, you know, that's a certain sort of person that maybe... Had she grown up with Aviva in her life, she'd know how to better, you know, handle her. Or you don't just storm into her room. That's for starters. And Aviva just wants, you know, she just wants somebody, anybody in her life, someone, friends, people like her. She's an outcast at school. And the mirror demon, Kali. It's like, yeah, I can give you everything you want. Sort of. I want you to steal all the people's powers. The three. Now's our chance. You could be the new Prue, and then I can take control of you. That was the main thrust of the story. And even though Aviva was being kind of bratty, kind of impulsive, lashing out at people, I didn't find it annoying at all, actually, for some reason. I was kind of with her. I was kind of rooting for her all the way to come around, you know? The other story, the Piper Phoebe Leo story, which is sort of a triangle and sort of not a triangle. Leo keeps mentioning Phoebe. That's what I got from this episode. He wasn't mentioning Piper to Phoebe, but he was mentioning Phoebe to Piper. And he wanted to know whether the whole lesbian thing was true. And there's only one reason you'd want to know that. He's into Phoebe. She's into him. Piper's also into him. They didn't resolve it in this episode, so it's gonna be an ongoing thing a little bit. So maybe he'll end up with Prue. In the end, well, she's single now that Andy dumped her. And the Andy Prue dating can't date. This is like kind of symbolic of their entire relationship so far and the whole story behind the relationship. Prue loves him, he loves her, but she can't tell him her secret. And she wasn't sure whether they could be in relationships and also be witches. And this episode embodied that idea. So, you know, Andy sort of had enough. He's sort of at that point where he's like, I wish you trusted me enough to tell me what's going on. I just wanted to watch the damn movie. I'm going to watch it on my own now. That's what he's thinking. So actually, a lot of, you know, the main story finished, but the other two are continuing into next episode, the episode after that. But, yeah, I had fun with this one. I loved how the Callie, she waits like half a second after somebody leaves a room and then suddenly she's fire Callie, you know? Really cool effect. It's just for the audience, you know? But just give it a bit. Make sure you're alone. Wait for the footsteps. Wait for the door to close before you revert to your real form. Just want to look up something. Oh, that episode was called The Fourth Sister. That's a good title for it. Oh, well, the actress who plays Kali is from New Zealand. Right. I couldn't quite place her accent. There was something about it that wasn't quite right. I was like, is she Irish? Is she, what is she? She's from New Zealand. So, thank you for watching another episode of Charmed. Looking forward to getting straight into episode 8 and see if they do continue any of the stories that they've left dangling this episode, or if we're going to take a little break, maybe have a just completely separate story on its own next episode and then go back to it. It's sort of what I expected from the start of the show, that there are these running arcs and also the kind of mystical case of the week. And that's a good way to do it, to weave the arcs into the stories each week. And you can kind of build the characters up, and I love the tiny little comments that are almost throwaway lines in the episodes. I mentioned that in the reaction, but like casually mentioning that it's Prue's dress, like, it's just so funny. Or the little jabs they all take at each other, you know? It is really funny. Anyway, I'm gonna go start watching episode 8, and I'll see you back for that one.